Hi students, good morning. Get yourselves ready with your teacher. I am Mrs. Anuradha Patnaik. I am in today's virtual class for class 10th students. I am going to teach the chapter 2 of political science. In your previous class, you all have noted that the vertical form of power sharing is the major form of power sharing adopted by most of the democratic countries of the world. This vertical form of power sharing is also popularly called as federal government. I am going to teach you on the chapter federalism. Before going deep into the chapter, let me again take you to the comparison which we have made between Sri Lanka and Belgium. You had noted that Belgium, constitution of the Belgium, made a major change. It brought a major change only to give power to the regional government. Is it means that the regional governments earlier had no power and role to play? No, it was not so. Regional governments had power and they had also a role to play. But the difference was that earlier the central government could withdraw the regional government's power at any time and regional governments depended upon the central government. But in the year 1993, a major change was brought. The major change was that the power of the central government was reduced and regional governments were given the constitutional powers. With this change, regional governments become powerful. They no longer dependent upon the central government to exercise power, and even the central government also could no longer withdraw the powers of the regional government at any time they wish. So this big step changed the Belgium from a unitary government to a federal government. That means when the Belgium constitution shared power between the central government and regional government, since then Belgium became a federal country. But Sri Lanka remained as a unitary country for all practical purposes. Now let me share with you the definition of federalism. Federalism is a form of government where power is divided between the central government and constituent units. In a federal form of government, mostly there are two sets of government. One at the center, that is the national government, which looks after the subjects of national importance. And the other is the state government, also called as provincial government, which looks after the day-to-day affairs of the administration. In this way, power is distributed between the center and the constituent units in a federal government. Here, both the central government and the state government are independent and they have their own jurisdiction to function. In this way, this is what a brief introduction on the chapter federalism. I am coming up in my next videos still much more information about federalism. Until then, keep yourself utmost safe. Thank you.